Hi everyone! So for today's video, ang pag-uusapan naman natin is kung paano mag-apply ng tourist at ng visit visa sa Italy Embassy. Now for those of you that are planning to go to Rome, to Milan, to Florence, to Venice, or kung saan mang part ng Italy, this is the right video for you. Ang first steps is for you to complete the requirement under the visa checklist. Ngayon, ang checklist for visit visa at saka sa tourist ay iisa. Unlike sa ibang embassy, merong sariling checklist for those applicant that are planning to apply for visit visa. They have their own checklist. But with Italy, isa lang ang checklist nila. So, magfo-fall lang siya sa isang category. Now, ang pagkakaiba lang is if you have an inviting person, there will be additional requirements for you compared dun sa tourist lang yung balak gawin. So, but then again, same lang siya. So, ang iti-check nyo dun is yung tourist visa, even though you're going to apply for a visit visa. The first requirement is a visa application form completed online. I'm going to have a direct link of the application form. So, punta lang kayo sa the description, click nyo lang yon, answer it, and then print it out. And then the second requirement is a 2 photo which must be attached dun sa application form nyo. So, yung photo na yon should be in passport format, which means na kailangan recent din siya, recent picture, like a week ago. Basta hindi siya more than a month. And then, kailangan makapture yung whole face, kailangan yung ears nyo naka-expose katulad ng ganyan. But kung paano kayo hinihingan ng, or kinukuha na ng picture when you get your passport. So, ganun yung kailangan. And make sure that you have a collar and then white background. The next requirement is your passport and your copies of your previous visa. So, for the passport, make sure na wala yung damage. Make sure, i-check nyo lahat ng pages kung may damage ba yan or wala. At saka i-check nyo yung expiration. Baka naman may expire na, malalaman nyo lang pag napasa nyo na yung passport nyo. And then, make sure na merong at least 2 blank pages yung passport nyo so that they can put the visa dun sa passport. At saka yung mga magiging entry stamp nyo during your travel going to Italy and back. And then, I also guys, please do make sure to bring all your previous passport, kahit nakailang renew ka na ng passport before, ipaputo-copy nyo nga pala yung mga visa stamp dun sa passport, yung current passport nyo. So, all those stamp, kailangan naka-photocopy siya, and then yung front page ng passport, yung kita yung details nyo, and then yung back page ng passport, kung saan kita yung parang contact details for emergency, something like that. The next requirement is a flight itinerary reservation. Please guys, do avoid buying a real ticket. Especially if mag-a-apply ka pa lang ng visa, there is no guarantee that your visa will be approved. And most of the time, yung mga flight ticket kasi, if you buy it agad-agad, tapos na-deny yung visa mo, there are times that the airline will not issue a refund kasi nag-request ka ng refund just because hindi ka makakaalis gawa ng na hindi ka nga nabigyan ng visa. To save money is kailangan ang kunin nyo na lang is ticket reservation or yung tinatawag natin na dummy ticket. If you don't have any idea what a dummy ticket is, I do have a video regarding that. Please do watch that. I'll pop it up here. And so, magiging familiar ka kung ano yung ginagawa ng dummy ticket, ano yung validity. And if you do need one, you can also avail my service for that. Pwede nyo siyang gamitin dun sa visa application nyo. But guys, ang dummy ticket is hindi nyo gagamitin pag aalis na kayo. Only for visa purposes, ha? Pag na-approve yung visa nyo, then that's the time you buy your own ticket. Next, a complete travel itinerary. So, this is your day-to-day itinerary in Spain. In Italy. Not just in Italy. Let's say, hindi lang Italy yung destination na gusto mong puntahan. You wanted to go to, let's say, 3 countries. So, lahat ng itinerary, lahat ng balak yung gawin to those countries included sa itinerary. Guys, make sure ang itinerary nyo is convincing. Make sure ang itinerary nyo is doable at hindi nakakalito. You can copy my format. I have a separate video for that. Also, a sample of my itinerary is on my website. My website will be on the description below. Please do visit that. And then after the itinerary, the next requirement would be a health insurance. Make sure ang health insurance is accredited sa lahat ng Schengen countries. Make sure that it has a minimum coverage of 30,000 euro. It does not mean, guys, na 30,000 euro yung babayaran nyo. 30,000 lang yung katumbas or yung cover ng insurance. But ang amount na babayaran nyo sa insurance when you get one is yung days na iko-cover ng insurance nyo. Just to give you an idea, ako, nag-apply ako ng... I buy insurance good for 74 days and I only paid around 5,000 pesos. I would advise to get a insurance with Standard Insurance, AXA, and then Pacific Cross. Lahat yan refundable if ever ma-denied ka. So yeah, contact nyo lang sila online or you can go to office branches ng mga insurance provider na yan. Next, cover letter stating the purpose of your trip to Italy. Cover letter is not on the checklist, but it is required. It is important and it is a must that you have one. Your cover letter is your bigger chance to get that visa approved. Kasi guys, ito yung only way para makapagpaliwanag kayo sa consul na kung bakit kailangan nila kayo bigyan ng visa, kung bakit deserving kayo ng visa. Kasi guys, hindi nyo naman makakaharap personally yung consul na magre-review ng application nyo. Meaning, hindi nyo ma-explain kung ano ba talaga yung mga documents nyo, bakit wala kayo nito, bakit ito lang yung pinasa mo. Wala kayong chance to do that. And the only chances to write it in a letter para maintindihan nila na, ah, kaya wala siyang ITR kasi ganito, ganyan. So, lahat ng requirements na wala ka or hindi mo maipapasa and ano yung intention mo, lahat yun nasa cover letter. If you wanted to know ano pa yung mga dapat nakalagay sa cover letter, ano yung format, please watch my previous video. It will be up here. And then, proof of accommodation for the whole duration of the intended stay in Italy. So, for tourists, ang kailangan nyong ipakita is hotel reservation or hostel reservation. Pwede din ang mga Airbnb or apartment as long as may mapapakita ka na proof. Merong mga site na pwede kang mag-reserve ng hotel, let's say booking.com, na hindi mo kailangan bayaran agad-agad. You can just reserve it for free and you can cancel it for free. So, better to use that. And then, for those applicant naman na mag-a-apply ng visit visa and mag-stay sa mga kaibigan nila, sa family nila, or sa bahay ng mga boyfriend, girlfriend nila, please make sure that you will have a invitation letter coming from your inviting person. So, dun sa invitation letter, make sure na kumpleto yung details regarding the inviting person, regarding you, kung paano kayo nagkakilala, anong relationship nyo, saan katutuloy, saan siya nakatira, and bakit kailangan bigyan ka ng visa, something like that. If you need the format for the invitation letter, how to write it, at saka sponsorship, again, I have a separate video for that. Visit my channel para makita nyo. Beside the invitation letter, kailangan po ng mga supporting documents to support lahat ng nakalagay sa invitation letter nyo. Kailangan ng passport or resident ID ng inviting person. Kailangan din ng proof of private accommodation called ito na naman tayo. Ang hirap na naman yung i-pronounce. So, kailangan nyo ng dichiarizon garazia o alloggio in Italian. Ang hirap, guys. Ilalagay ko na lang yung direct link nung form na to. And I'll have it here para kita nyo kung ano yung sinasabi ko. So, please do download that and ibigay nyo dun sa inviting person nyo para sila yung mag-sagot ng form. And then, kailangan din, if ever yung inviting person nyo is a family member, husband or wife, sibling, kailangan mag-attach kayo ng proof of relationship nyo, like yung birth certificate or marriage certificate. Beside yung mga marriage or birth certificate, pwede nilang gamitin from boyfriend, girlfriend is a picture together. If hindi pa kayo nakikita, pwede nyong gamitin is a screenshot of your chat conversation or video conversation. Next requirement would be a proof of sufficient financial means. Of course, this is one of the very most important requirement is mapatunayan nyo sa console na afford at kaya nyong mag-travel sa Italy. Make sure that you have a bank certificate. I-request yan sa bank kasi kailangan ay may pirma and signature ng bank official. And then yung banking statement, request for 6 months. There are times they might request for 1 year. Actually, na nag-apply ako sa Italy, ang dala-dala ko noon 6-month banking statement and then hinanapan nila ako ng 1 year. So, kailangan kong bumalik. So, to save you some time, I think it's best to print out or to request sa banko nyo ng 1 year statement na. So, just in case mag-request pa sila more than 6 months, you're ready. May maipapasa ka na agad on the spot. Tanggap din yung mga international credit card. So, pakita lang kayo ng 6-month statement to 1 year. And then, for minors, yung mga estudyante natin dyan, for your proof of financial means, ang kailangan nyo is yung proof of economic means ng parents at ng legal guardian nyo. So, malamang madalas sa mga estudyante may sponsor and yung sponsor nila family and parents. So, make sure na may proof of sponsorship kayo and proof of relationship. If you're someone that won't be able to finance everything sa travel nyo, okay lang kasi pwede naman kayo maghanap ng sponsor. But make sure si sponsor willing ka talagang gastusan. At hindi lang willing, kundi meron din siyang pera para ipang-support sa'yo. With that, make sure na kompleto ka ng supporting document from your sponsor. Make sure that you have a sponsorship letter or yung tinatawag nating letter of guarantee. And then make sure also that you have a proof of relationship dahil hindi pwedeng basta-basta sino ang mag-sponsor sa'yo. Kailangan mapatunayan mo sa console na related ka sa person na yon, kaya willing ka niyang sponsoran. So, again, ito yung mga birth certificate, pictures together, or screenshot ng mga chat conversation nyo. And then, if ever ang sponsor nyo is si boyfriend, si girlfriend, or si fiance, please make sure na meron kayong photocopy ng mga visa stamp or entry stamp dun sa passport nila. At saka scan copy ng resident ID nila. So, if you wanted to know the complete list or kung how to apply with the sponsor, please watch my previous video regarding that. So, mas magiging mas malinaw para sa inyo. The next requirement is a proof of civil status. So, para malaman nila kung single ka ba or kung married ka, kung divorced ka. So, although certificate needs to be coming from PSA. Next, proof of your will of return. So, ito yung proof of strong ties or yung proof of rootedness. This is to show to the embassy na meron kang babalikan sa Pilipinas at meron kang reason para bumalik ng Pilipinas. This can be in terms of your employment or if you're someone na nag-aaral, syempre kailangan balikan mo yung schooling mo. If you have a small business or if you have properties, investments, you have cars, or you also have, let's say, wala ka ng mga to, but meron kang, let's say, anak, meron kang baby pa, or ikaw ang only child, or ikaw na lang yung anak na single, and your parents are senior citizen, ikaw ang nag-aalaga, or meron kang parents na inaalagaan kasi may sakit. So, those things can be used as strong ties. But to give you a complete list and more broad na pwede nyong gamitin na strong ties, please watch my recent video regarding that. Next requirement will be evidence of employment status. Those people that are employed, make sure that you have COE. Make sure ng COE nyo is complete ng full name mo, complete address, telephone number ng office, detail regarding sa position mo, detail regarding sa income mo, and regarding sa duration kung gaano ka nakatagal nagtatrabaho sa kumpanya. Please make sure na lahat ito is nasa COE mo. Make sure that you have your current bank statement for the latest 6 months. If wala, pwede rin ng payslip, guys. Basta recent 3 months payslip. And then make sure that you also have a leave approved, guys. Approved leave permission from your employer or no objection letter. Of course, kailangan makita ni consul na pinayagan ka ng boss mo na magbakasyon sa Europe. Kasi if not, bakit ka nila papayagan kung yung mismong boss mo hindi ka pinayagan? I know sa Pilipinas, mahirap mag-apply ng leave. But then again, guys, you need to find ways if you really wanted to tour around Europe. Next, income tax return. Importante to. Kailangan makita ng consul na you're a responsible citizen of the Philippines at nagbabayad ka ng tax. Kasi dun pa lang, if makikita na nila yung responsibilidad mo, at least they know that you can be also responsible when you go to other country at babalik ka sa Pilipinas. So, if ever wala kang ITR, you don't need to worry kasi baka naman exempted ka sa pagkakaroon or sa pagbabayad ng tax. Make sure na i-check nyo kung exempted ba kayo or kung hindi naman kayo exempted, if malaki ang sweldo nyo pero hindi lang kayo nagbabayad ng tax nyo, magkakaproblema kayo dyan. Now, if you're someone that is earning less than 250,000 annually, then you're exempted to pay tax. So if you wanted to know more about that, since hindi siya talaga visa related, hindi rin ako familiar sa mga tax, something like that, please i-check nyo yan sa accountant nyo or kung sino man pwede nyo tanungan with that. The next one is for those people that are self-employed or owner ng mga business or even just a small business. So make sure that you have a copy of your business license or yung tinatawag natin na DTI. Beside DTI, make sure that you have a mayor or barangay business permit. And then make sure also that you have an income tax return if you have a big business. If you have a small business, let's say yung mga sari-sari store, online boutique, or basta maliit tas hindi ganun kalaki yung annual salary nyo, just explain sa cover letter nyo why you don't have ITR. And then, company's bank statement for the latest 6 months. At saka yung bank certificate. If you have a business, but you don't have a separate bank account for that business, kasi ang ginagawa nyo, diretso na agad sa personal account nyo, that is still fine. Hindi nyo kailangan gumawa ng ibang bank account for your business. Ipaliwanag nyo lang na since maliit lang naman yung business nyo, idinadiretso nyo na lang sa personal bank account nyo. Next is for those students. Sa mga estudyante natin dyan na gusto rin makapunta ng Italy, it's still possible, guys. Just make sure na meron kang proof of enrollment. If, let's say, you're going to have a vacation, hindi siya school days, let's say bakasyon, summer vacation, so you don't need a proof of enrollment. Ang kailangan mo is proof of enrollment for the next school year. Para makita ng embassy na kailangan mo talaga bumalik ng Pilipinas kasi enrolled ka na for the next school year. And of course, enrolled, bayad na yun, so kailangan mo bumalik. Yun yung pwede mong gamitin actually din na strong ties bilang estudyante. Next is a approved letter of absent from your school and university. Kailangan payagan ka ng school mo na magbakasyon if magbabakasyon ka during school days. And then a photocopy of your school ID para makita nila na talagang currently you're studying or estudyante ka ng school na yun. Next is for retiree. Ang ipapakita nyo lang po is yung pension statement of the latest 6 months. To make sure na meron kang nakompleto mo lahat ng mga requirements that I mentioned, if hindi mo na take note now, I'm going to have a direct link in the description ng checklist ng tourist visit visa coming from the embassy website. Please do check that out, guys. So, ayan na, okay na. Let's say, nakompleto mo na lahat ng requirements na sinabi ko. Now, all you need to do is log your application sa Via PH Center. Via PH Center is yung visa facility or yung service na ng Italy na tumatanggap ng mga short-term visa. Ngayon kasi, ang Via, pwede kang mag-apply walk-in. Hindi mo na kailangan mag-set ng appointment katulad sa ibang embassy ng BPS, kailangan by appointment. During the application, yung pagpapasa ng requirements, doon din nila kukuhanin yung biometrics nyo. So, once they get your biometrics, the third step is for you to pay for the visa. Yung visa, ang babayaran nyo, hindi lang yung visa, kundi yung processing fee. For the visa fee, nag-increase na siya last February 2. So, the new amount that you need to pay for adult age 12 and above is 80 euro. In peso, it's 4,528. And para naman sa mga age 11 years old up to 6 years old, ang babayaran niyo po is 40 euro. In peso, it's 2,264. And sa lahat ng mga bata age 6 and below, free na po yan. So on top of the visa fee, there is a processing fee. And then let's say, okay na, nabayaran mo na yung visa fee, ready na, uuwi ka na. All you need to do is the last step is to pray. The last step is to wait and track your application. At the same time, for you to pray, go to church and pray. Pray, pray, pray. Kasi guys, hindi mahira, hindi ganun kabilis pag-apply sa Italy Embassy. Italy is one of the strictest, actually, pagdating sa visa application. Even though, daming na-approve, ang dami ring na-denied. So make sure when you apply to Italy Embassy, you have good, complete requirements. So yeah guys, those are the steps and those are the requirements for you to be able to apply for a tourist visa. I do hope that this video help you kung pag-ready nyo sa darating na application nyo. If you do have any question, if there is something na confusing, or if there is something na gusto nyong linawin, feel free to do that. Just have your question in the comment section below. I'll try my best to answer as much as possible. Pero if not, you feel free to also email me or message me on Facebook. Guys, I do have a Facebook group. It's a Schengen Visa Tip group. So I'll post tips there. And then yung mga members doon may mga experience na din. Please do join that para magkaroon tayo ng group kung saan nagtutulungan tayo na magkaroon ng visa. I'll have that in the description below. Again, my website is here and visit that if you do need any help with your application. So I'll see you guys in my next video and please do subscribe. Bye!